Hi mommies, this is Tanya Noor's mom. So the much awaited video is here and today I am going to be speaking all about sippy cups. Why do we need sippy cups? When to introduce them? And which is the best sippy cup for your baby? So what is the main goal of introducing a sippy cup to your baby? So the main goal is to make your baby get used to a normal open cup, the ones we drink out of, till the baby is around 1.2 to 1.5 years of age. So that is the whole aim of why sippy cups came into play. Now, what do sippy cups enable? So sippy cups, number one, help in weaning your baby off bottles. So it is recommended that you should wean your babies off bottles by 1 year of age or maximum by 15 months. Why? Because continued use of bottle, even when the baby's certain teeth are out, can lead to tooth decay. It can lead to tooth misalignment. It does not lead to proper facial development. It doesn't help in, exercising the face muscles. So hence it is recommended to wean off your baby off the bottle by that age. Now second, sippy cups help in proper oral motor skill development. So what is that? It means just exercising the entire face muscles. So your lips, your jaws, your tongue, and your palate. Then they assist in proper speech development. And lastly, they assist in proper facial development and teeth alignment. Right? So the aim is that by the time your baby reaches, say, 15 months or maximum, I would say 18 months, your baby should be using an open cup to drink all liquids other than breast milk directly from the breast. Right? So now what is the recommended age to start a sippy cup? You can start it as soon as your baby turns 6 months. Now there are so many sippy cups in the market. Which is the best one? So I'm going to be talking about each type of sippy cup available and its pros and cons. Right? So the first kind of sippy cups are spout cups. So there are soft spout cups and hard spout cups. So like this is a soft spout cup and this is a hard spout cup. Right? So now what are these spout cups about? So now they are very easy for transitioning your baby from a bottle. Why? Because they have a similar mechanism like the bottle nipple. Second, they are very easy to hold on to. And thirdly, they are spill free. Like you won't have any spills with sippy cups. And lastly, they help in developing proper hand-eye coordination of the baby. So proper hand-eye coordination is that these cups, baby has to learn how to hold them, to lift them and then tilt to drink. So this is the proper hand-eye coordination. However, so these were the good things about spout cups. Now the bad thing is that it doesn't do much about your oral motor skill development because the mechanism is same as that of the bottle. The baby is just sucking on it, right? So same things, doesn't lead to proper speech development, proper facial development, proper oral motor skill development, can lead to tooth decay. So all these problems arise. Hence, pediatricians or even pediatric dentists do not recommend this cup to be used for a longer period of time. Please listen to me carefully, longer period of time. Now let's move on to second type of cups. The second type of cups are straw cups. So the example is here. This is a straw cup, right? Now, pediatricians prefer this over the spout cups. Why? Because number one, it helps in oral motor skill development. Why? Because the baby has to learn to pull the tongue at the back of the mouth to suck. So that is exercising all the jaws, jaw area and the tongue and the lips, everything. Also, because it is helping in this, it is also helping in speech development. But now the problem with this is that it does not lead to proper hand-eye coordination. Why? Because usually these straw cups have like a weighted straw at the bottom, so the baby can suck from any angle and the water will come. So they are not learning that mechanism of holding, lifting and tilting their body to drink. But still, these are preferred over spout cups. Now the third kind of cup, which is very popular among dentists, pediatricians and even a lot of moms, are the 360 degree trainer cup. So this is how they look. It is just an open cup with a cap, which is spill free. The baby can drink from any side. It definitely helps in proper oral motor skill development, because the baby is using all muscles. Helps in hand-eye coordination because the baby has to tilt. And lastly, it makes it easy for the baby to move to an open cup, right? So that is why these are preferred so much. Now lastly, we have open cups, and open cups are nothing but like plain cups like we have at home. So this can act like an open cup, and the ultimate aim is that the baby should be using this by 1.5 years of age. Now if you know, for breastfeeding babies who've never taken a bottle, you can go on two routes. One is you follow this the spout cup, straw cup, and you know, that kind of route. And the other is you directly introduce open cup to your baby, because the baby, your baby has never had the bottle. And for formula feeding baby, again, you can either move that route or directly go for the open cups. Now, there are two kinds of babies. One that easily take to an open cup when introduced at 6 months. Yes, it involves a lot of spillage and their clothes getting wet and frequent changes, but they take to it very easily and it all works out very smoothly. But there are certain babies who like a subtler transition, and they are not, they don't accept such a sudden transition suddenly, and it's absolutely okay. So hence, for such babies, please don't start stressing or fretting about, you know, my baby is not taking an open cup, his teeth will get misaligned, or you know, all those worries. Go slow by slow, try different cups for your babies, and because all of them are helping in their oral motor skill development in some or the other way. So try different cups. Second, if your baby is not taking water in a cup, try giving your baby milk, breast milk or formula milk in a cup, because that they're used to and they might, you know, take the cup easily. Third, you know, you should restrict using all these cups, except the open cup, to meal times. Just restrict it to them and either give water in it or milk. Avoid giving any sugary drinks or juices in it, because it just leads to tooth decay, especially if you're using the spout cup or the straw cup. So avoid that. Lastly, don't panic. All babies will eventually move on to an open cup. Just be strong, I mean, be have a good willpower, be dedicated to it and work towards it, and make your baby practice as much as you can. So just give your baby the cup also with the cap on, just to practice the whole hand-eye coordination. Now, you know, before I go on to which cups I use, I'll just like to say that even if you want to use this spout cup, straw cup, it's absolutely okay. But remember, everything is okay in moderation and everything is bad in excess. So if you are planning to, you know, take this subtler transition and move from one type of cup to the other, just ensure that you don't prolong the use of it, right? 2-3 months is fine, or even 6 months is fine, but don't, you know, move way past than that, because then that will lead to all those problems that I just discussed, right? So everything in moderation is all right. It's okay if your baby is using a spout cup. Nothing's gonna go wrong with his or her teeth suddenly, but have a plan in place. I will discuss that plan right now when I'm telling you what I'm using and how I'm using, right? So now let me tell you what kind of sippy cups I am using and what is the plan that I have in place for Noor. So initially, when she turned 6 months old, as you all know, I use the Dr. Brown's feeding bottle for Noor. So Dr. Brown's also has spout nipples, which act as a transition bottle. So I bought these nipples. This is a spout nipple, as you can see. So I used this instead of the normal nipple and got, you know, made her used to this in the sixth month of her life. Now around 7.5 months, I started with the soft spout cup. So I tried a lot of them. I've tried the hard spout ones, not good at all. Mothercare, then I tried Kiko's soft spout cup. That was also not very comfortable for her. Finally, we chose this. This is the Philips Avent soft spout cup. It's a 200 ml bottle. It is the perfect size for your small baby to hold. Gives exactly the kind of practice that your baby needs. And always try to first buy a cup with handles. So yeah, I'm currently using this, and I will be using this for say another 15 days or so. Then I'll be moving on to straw cups. So I have this Munchkin weighted straw cup. It's a great cup, good handles, good size, not too big, not too small. So I'll be using this. Then around the nine and a half months, you know, because that time your baby gets around 3-4 teeth and they start to bite on everything. So all your spouts, all your straws are going to be chewed off. So for that, I'm going to be using this. This is the Munchkin Bite Proof Sippy Cup. So it's a lovely cup and this is bite proof. So your baby can't chew this off. So I'm going to be using this after that. And around 10 and a half months of age, I'm going to move on to this Munchkin 360 degree trainer cup. So I'm going to start using this, and I'm going to be very rigid on my timelines so that I can at least move to an open cup by 15 months of age. So that's my plan. And at the moment I am on track, but let's see how things goes. But this is it, and I'm not stressing so much about my baby's teeth or facial development, because I know that using such a cup for 2-3 months will not affect her development at all. So this is all about sippy cups, and there are lots of them in the market, lots of brands, and you can test different ones and, you know, see what your baby likes, or you can just pick whatever you like, order something and just go with the flow. But other than that, these are what I'm using, and I will be posting links for all of these which I'm using, which I like, in the description below. So please check them out so that, you know, I can be saved from the wrath of hundreds of messages asking me, please send me the link for this. So this is all about sippy cups, and I hope this video was helpful for you. Keep writing, keep commenting which sippy cups work for your baby or didn't, and keep also suggesting topics for my next post, because that's really helpful for me. Thank you. Have a nice day and take care. Bye-bye.